Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to discuss about Spark real-time interview questions with answers from 21 to 25 out of 850 questions. Before going to see the questions, please subscribe my channel, like it and click on bell button. Today's question is how to convert RDD to data frame. So here I have provided an example, that is case class with customer class, class name, and also customer ID is integer type, customer name string, and last name is string type. So I am creating data frame where people df equals spark dot spark context text file of, I have given this CSV file path, and then I am applying a split on top of the map, and then I am applying map operation, map transformation on top of all the records, and then at the end I am converting into data frame. So we have to remember these steps. Okay, how to convert. So here I have provided you converting RDD to data frame. So these steps we have to remember it. So next one is how to remove special character hash from 100 of columns in data frame. So I have provided you the coding here. You can use this code in during the interviews. That is val columns equal to customer ID, customer name, separated by pipe. And then I am splitting it based on this pipe. And then I am applying the map transformation on top of that. Wherever the hash is there, I want to remove it, right? So I am stripping margin I am using, and then I am provided inside the hash symbol. Now I am creating the data frame with all the columns. This is the converting, removing the special character hash from all the columns in a data frame. Next one, how to calculate executor memory. This is most important, and in almost all interviews, the interviewers will ask this question. So here, configuration of the cluster is as below. We are taking 10 nodes of the cluster, and each node has a core, 16 cores minus one. For operating systems, we are giving one core in each node, and then each node RAM equals 61 GB RAM. So for Hadoop daemons and all, we give 1 GB of the RAM. So we are allocating one core for the operating system and 1 GB for Hadoop daemons in each node. So here number of cores, now we calculate each one cores and then executor memory. Now so number of cores is number of concurrent tasks an executor can run in parallel. So the general rule of thumb for optimal value is 5. So here we have to remember thumb rule for optimal value is 5. So number of cores should be 5, so that our system performance, the job performance will be good. So we have fixed number of cores 5. Now we are going for executors, number of executors identification. So number of executors equal to number of cores divided by concurrent task, that is 5 in general. So 15. Now we have 15 cores. We have seen right here, we have 16 cores total and 61 GB. One core is given for operating system 1 GB for Hadoop daemon. So 15 cores and 60 GB RAM is there in each node. So 15 by 5 means 3. 3 is number of executor in each node. So 3 executors. Number of nodes into number of executor in each node equal to number of executor for Spark job. So 10 into 3. So that is number of executors equal to 30. So 3 into 10 nodes. So total nodes are, we have taken in total nodes 10. So in overall executors are 10 nodes and each node 3 executors. So 10 into 3 is 30 executors we have. So that is very, very important in Spark interview questions. Definition of Spark SQL. Spark SQL is a Spark interface to operate with structured as great as the semi-structured data value. You should this ability to place data value of various structured data specialties like text file value, JSON files value, Parquet file value, among other data. This is the general meaning. What is meant by Parquet file? Parquet is defined by a columnar format file supported many of data value system processing. Spark SQL has been performed both of the read and write data operations function with Parquet file. It's supposed to be one of the best high data analytics formats so greatly. So thank you, friends. The remaining questions will be given in the upcoming videos. We'll see in the next video. Thank you, friends.